Running design projects means you have a lot of different things to keep track of, from mood board images to inspiration and feedback from your clients. And it takes a lot of work to keep that organized and make sure that you have everything when you need it and are ready to work on something. I'm a super visual person, so I had a really hard time with all of these different organizing systems that basically was just like a list with file names. So I was super excited when I discovered Milanote, and I've been using it for my branding business for quite some time now. I thought I would take you through how I use Milanote for my business, how I use it to collaborate with my team members, and I want to show you both how I kind of organize the different projects so that you have a really easy way to find everything, but also some of the key functions in Milanote that I think it makes it such a good tool. So let's dig in and start looking at the actual way that I organize. So the very first thing I wanted to show you is how I have an overview of all of my different clients. So in Milanote, you're able to create boards using this little menu on the left. You have all these different options. Since a lot of my projects are branding projects, which follow a really similar structure, what you can do is actually create a board that is a template for how all of your branding projects are going to work. So I'll show you how to do that. So all you have to do to convert it to a template is to click on the board and to right click and then choose convert to template. That way you can just copy that template every time that you're creating a new branding project. So I organize all my projects into active projects and paused projects because sometimes someone might need more time, maybe they're sick or something else comes up. So I like to just keep an eye on that. We're gonna go into the actual client board to see how I organize here. And this is where I have the different projects. So the same client has all of their projects in the same board. This is a super easy way for me to get an overview. And in some cases where I have clients that, let's say, have continuous retainers or other projects, I can just grab a column, let's say, and call it retainer. And then I can drag in these different boards so that I have a way to organize similar type of projects into the same thing. And so you could easily, let's say, call this retainer March, for example. And that way you know that this is the work you've been doing this specific month for that retainer work. So really easy way to keep everything organized. What I'd also like to show you is that you can actually change the icons. So in this case, these are the default icons. But if you want to make it branded or something else, add the company logo or something, you can just click on it and you can choose the icon. And here you can search for an icon, like they have these different ones around branding. So it kind of auto notices what type of content it is. Or you can upload your own image. So here you can upload something that is representing this board, if you have lots of time and want to make it extra organized. So to show you how this works, I thought I would go into the branding one to show you how I set up each of the projects. So it's a little bit of nesting here. So in a typical branding project, what I like to have is background information, which includes the timeline, so a clear overview of all the different deadlines. I like to upload the discovery report here. So if you've seen me do my videos on discovery or on Olibrief, you might have seen how I create a report from that. And so that's what I upload here. And then I also like to have a brief in case the client has sent me their own brief. And if they haven't, I might just add like my own document with something of the email correspondence, for example. I also like to have just a quick overview of the feedback. So I will add the different stages for the mood board, for concept iteration, and so forth, just so I know exactly what we agreed upon and I can tick them off. So if you want to do the same thing, you just have to add a column. You can name it feedback, for example, and then you just add a to-do list. So you just drag that over there, and if you start typing different tasks, you can see that it will suggest that you can have a title for it. So we can choose yes, and we can ask, say, mood board, for example. So this is a super easy way to organize. You see, you can reorder the tasks, do things like that. So I find Milanote not only visually appealing, but also very, very easy to learn. So besides this overview information that I have of the project, I then like to have another board for each of the stages that I like to work visually on. So you could, of course, have things for brainstorming, for discovery, for things like that, if that's the way that you like to work. For me, these two stages, like mood boarding and concepting, are the two most important ones for me to work visually on, so that's why I have here. So to show you a little bit more about the key functions that I really love about Milanote, we're gonna dig into the concepts one. So the very first thing I want to bring up is just to take you a little bit very quickly through the menu on the left. I'm not going to go into like a super detail because Milanote has lots of great YouTube videos on all the functions. I want to bring out some highlights for anyone who's a designer who really likes to use this. So the first thing I want to show you is how to add pictures and the really great ways that you can do this. So the first way is you can just click add image or upload. Both of those will be great ways to either find images that are part of pixels, or you can upload your own. So if you upload your own image, you can choose the different ones that you want, and then all you have to do is you just drag them over, resize them, put them whatever way that you find helpful. And they will keep them in this panel organized for you so that it doesn't just go everywhere on your board and kind of block out something important, for example. The next way I want to show you how to add an image, which I just love, it's so easy and flexible, is you can just go to your web browser and you can just copy any image that you find on, let's say, Pinterest or Unsplash, or basically anywhere, to be honest. So let's say we want to go to Pinterest and we want to look for, let's say, a shoe brand logo. So let's say that we really like this one and I just go copy image and I go to Milanote and I command paste and there it is. So you actually don't even have to save things to your computer, which is something I really appreciate because I used to always save everything and then put it into Illustrator and then, you know, you just get really messy computers with so many different files that you're only going to use once. So I really like collecting everything like this and being able to copy and paste it. You're also able to upload all kinds of different file types, so not like images and text only, but you can add like Adobe Illustrator or InDesign files, for example. So let's say you've been working on this branding project and you know you're gonna have a week's break and you just want to upload what you have and then kind of remember that that's exactly the files that you're working with. That way you can keep track of everything and you don't have to look for anything when you're coming back to the project. Next up, I want to show you something really cool, which is the color palette function. So especially when you're working on things like mood boards or color inspiration for concepting, it's really nice to have it visualized. And so you just go to the little dots here if you can't see it and you have color and you drag that out. This will create a swatch. So here you can go onto this and you can just change the color. You can either put like the different codes or you can just kind of explore the color and see what works. But I also really like using the color dropper. So here you can use it to grab it from one of your pictures. So if you have a mood board or something you've created previously, this is a great way to grab those colors and start building out your mood board. Another really great function is the scribble function. So if you click again on the dots and you can see here, they have a sketch function. So you can draw that out and it will create a little window where you can create a defined kind of area to sketch. So if you just double click it, you get an area. So let's say you have an idea for a logo that you just have as a concept, but you don't really know exactly what it's going to look like. You can just create a quick sketch where you're kind of defining the key features. Maybe you're writing something to define what that means. You can start to have a little bit of just an idea that you can just put somewhere together with your other concept ideas. And as you can see, you can of course use these different columns here to organize your core ideas, your concepts into different columns to keep it from getting really messy or overwhelming. If you don't want it to be confined and you just want to draw something on top of what you've done, you can click on the draw function and that allows you to, let's say, create something really interesting with the actual images that you have. So you can create interactive elements together with the other stuff that you have on your board. I don't know about you, but I often find lots of cool ideas when I'm looking for inspiration and I don't really know exactly how I'm going to use them, but I come across something I know is going to be useful and I want to save it somewhere. So one function that you can also use is to link to stuff. So if you want to organize your ideas and have quick access to them, I like to create a column for that just to keep it somewhere I know where to find it. So what I do is just create a column and then you can either, let's call that ideas. And then we can either just put a note in and then paste a link to something, or we can create a link directly. So there's a link block for that where you just paste the URL. And let's go grab one. So let's, for example, say that I really find this packaging super interesting. There's something about the colors here, something about the sustainability that I love. All I have to do is go copy the link, go back into Milanote, and paste the URL. And usually it creates a little thumbnail as well, so it helps you keep those ideas organized. You don't have to remember what it is that link was. So let's get things a little organized. So I'm gonna say that this belongs to concept one. So we're gonna add these different elements in here. And so you can start to see how this is built up as a way to organize your thoughts. And you could have, let's say, these as a separate one. So then you can add a concept two, let's say. And we can start dragging these things into there. So sometimes I think it's a good idea to have just kind of a one column for ideas that you're just not sure where they're gonna go, but it's something that you like. So that's also something you can do if you want. The last thing I wanna talk about is collaboration, because that is something that is super useful if you have, let's say, someone who is on your team or even a client sometimes. If you want to invite them to, let's say, look at a mood board and leave comments directly on the mood board, that is something that is super easy for them to do. So let me show you that. All you have to do is go up to the little share button, and here you'll have two options. And I really love that they're using invite via link, because I always like to kind of onboard my clients or my collaborators a little and tell them in an email saying, hi, I'm sending you a link to this. This is what I am expecting. This is what I'm hoping. And this is what this is. So all you have to do is click this little toggle if you want to activate the link. There are two different ways to share this. So you can add an editor, which means they have the same access as you. They can edit, they can delete, they can remove things, and they can, of course, add and build out the boards for you. Another option is to do a share and read only link. So if you're just doing it as them looking at it, they don't actually have to have an account, they can view it. But if you want to, let's say, have them comment, react, draw on something, then they will need to create a password and an account. It's totally free, so it's a good thing to do. It's really easy for clients to use, but just a heads up that they do have to have an account. So that's something that you might want to preface when you're sending that invite. You can also set a password, let's say, if you want to make sure that no one is gonna accidentally see this link for some reason in the company if it's something confidential. And so all you have to do is to copy the link and then send that to them. Or if you want, you could enter their email address straight here. Once they have access, they're able to leave comments. So you see here in the menu, there's a field called comments. So we can drag it here and we can say, love the colors, for example. You can also, of course, drag this to be in whatever place you want, if you try a little bit. And you can also leave reactions to things. So let's say you have this image here and you really love it and you want to express that, you can add a reaction. So again, in the left-hand menu, we can leave an emoji, and that is a way for us to show that this is something that we really love. So let's say you're doing something completely different with Milanote, and you're, let's say, doing a workshop where you're asking people to vote for the different images that they think would best represent the brand. That is something you could also do through these reactions. If you really love being organized and you want to know more about how to organize and collaborate with your clients, I did a video on how to create branding project setups and templates with Trello so that you and your client can collaborate. And so if that's something that you're interested in, I'm gonna put that video on the screen. Thank you so much for watching, and good luck with your projects. See you next time.